All of this may have great impact on your life in the years ahead, and you need to know about it. So be sure and request The Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse. Along with the booklet, if you're not already a subscriber, we'll be sending you a sample copy of the Plain Truth magazine. It analyzes world news in the light of Bible prophecy, along with other articles dealing with the family and social issues. I'll be offering this free literature again at the end of today's program. Now, John's account doesn't end with the white and red horses. Close behind them comes yet another.
When he opened the third seal, I heard the third living creature say, "Come and see." And I looked, and behold, a black horse. And he who sat on it had a pair of scales in his hand. And I heard a voice in the midst of the four living creatures saying, "A quart of wheat for a penny, and three quarts of barley for a penny. Do not harm the oil and the wine."
The black horse, the symbol of famine. Coming hard on the hoofbeats of the red horse of war, we have the effect of acute food deprivation. This is just as Christ said. Notice Luke 21, the beginning of verse 11. "And there will be great earthquakes in various places and famine." What's the effect of revolutions and wars on survivors? Even though the fighting may stop, the land is ravaged, and food shortage and famine are the result. It happened in Europe after the last world war, in Cambodia a decade ago, and it's happening in Ethiopia and Mozambique even today. War wreaks havoc on agriculture. And there's every reason to believe that a nuclear war would eventually cause global disaster. Many scientists confirm that the side effects of such a war would cause even more death than the immediate result of the blast. Firestorms would produce enormous clouds of smoke and dust, limiting the amount of sunlight reaching the Earth. Some have dubbed this phenomenon the nuclear winter. Its effects on agriculture and human life would be catastrophic. According to Cornell University scientist Mark Harwell, most of the world's population, as many as 4 billion people, could starve to death in a nuclear war rather than die of burns or radiation. Rather than reflecting images of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, a modern nuclear war would, for most people of the world, much more resemble current images of Ethiopia and the Sudan. So ironically, the death toll from famine could be even greater than from outright war. And that fact is in perfect agreement with the sequence of events recorded by John. And so this is the grim picture we see unfolding as the third horseman rides out of the pages of prophecy. Some nations, by carefully rationing their reserves, might survive. But for millions of others, there'll be no alternative but hunger and starvation. Jesus Christ warned of these consequences long before we recognized the awful potential of nuclear winter. You see, these horsemen of the apocalypse ride one after the other with a cumulative impact. The one compounds the effect of the other. So these three horses, symbolizing counterfeit Christianity, escalating warfare, and devastating famine, leave turmoil and suffering behind them. But tragically, there's one more horseman to come.
When he opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth living creature saying, "Come and see." And I looked, and behold, a pale horse. And the name of him who sat on it was Death, and Hell followed with him. And power was given to them over a fourth of the earth to kill with sword, with hunger, with death, and by the beasts of the earth.
This final awesome sight symbolizes sickness and death. At a point in the future, civilization will break down, from the combined crushing impact of all four horsemen. It'll be everyone for him or herself. Jesus himself said pestilences or disease epidemics would be part of these world-devastating events. And so it seems even nature itself turns against humanity as wild animals further ravage the weakened, hungry population. Epidemics carried by animals may even be a factor in the death of many for whom no medical care will be available. When we let the Bible interpret its own symbols, we see these horsemen represent trends that occur throughout history, but they greatly intensify in the years just before Jesus Christ returned to this earth. The four horsemen foretell a time of unparalleled horror facing civilization. It's a frightening picture, and these are not things we prefer to think about. The book of Revelation seems totally negative, but it is very real. It's the world we live in, and we need to wake up and understand where it's heading. What we have to realize is that world events are all moving to a conclusion. Where will you be when all these things begin to coincide? Jesus said that some people would be so terrified by world events that they'd die from fear. Notice Luke 21 and verse 26. Men's hearts failing them from fear and the expectation of those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of heaven will be shaken. But what about you? Will you be spared? Will you survive? Well, there's much, much more to the apocalypse than these prophecies in the first few chapters. Despite all we've seen, the book has a powerful and encouraging conclusion. Humanity does win in the end, but not before terrible lessons have been learned. Remember, the Apocalypse, or Book of Revelation, and the outline of prophecy in Matthew 24 have one central theme in common: the coming of the kingdom of God to this earth, the restoration of wise, just government under Christ's rule. A better world is coming, a kinder, gentler, peaceful world, where people will live without fear of destruction. So here in the Bible, written in advance, are the major events leading up to the very end of man's present civilization and the beginning of tomorrow's world. This is a book for our time. When John first saw these things, their final fulfillment was a great way off, but now we're much closer, and they'll likely happen in the lifetime of most of us. To understand, you need to know more, and you need to know what to do to prepare for these earth-shattering events. This same book that foretells the coming of the four horsemen also shows how to be protected from what's ahead. Here are Christ's own words about that protection. They're recorded in Luke chapter 21 and verse 36. Be always on the watch and pray that you may be able to escape all that is about to happen, and that you may be able to stand before the Son of Man. Christ promised protection for those who heed the warning, stay alert, change their lives, and start making right choices. This era of man's civilization has almost run its course. The heartbreak and uncertainty, the cruelty, ruthlessness, and suffering will come to an end. But before they do, the four horsemen complete their ride. To help you understand world conditions and these startling biblical images, we'd like to offer you this week's free literature, The Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse, and the Plain Truth Magazine. We hope to see you again next week. Till then, thanks for joining us. I'm David Hulme for The World Tomorrow.
The preceding program and all literature were produced and sponsored by the Worldwide Church of God.